click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this video we are going to see a simple MATLAB demonstration for the performance of minimum square error method, which is also known as the Wiener filtering. As we have gone through the earlier inverse filtering for the purpose again to have the image restoration, also the approach of pseudo inverse filtering we have seen. The understanding of Wiener filtering, let us implement and test it onto the various types of images in this particular MATLAB program. So let us proceed further. So this is our topic titled MATLAB program for the purpose of Wiener filtering in image restoration. Now the task to have this MATLAB programming shall be the same that we have opted for inverse and pseudo inverse filtering. That is, first of all, reading the image, then degrading the image shall be added with the noise. Either the noise shall be of the Gaussian type also, or simply the additive white Gaussian noise, AWGN, what we say that we can have for the purpose of image degradation. Then we shall be applying the Wiener type of filtering, and lastly observing the results of the input and the output images at various stages, we can say. So let us switch to the MATLAB environment for programming purpose. So here we have the MATLAB environment provided. So for programming purpose, we take untitled script here, the very first line. As usual, I shall be mentioning the purpose of having this particular program. So let us comment the first line. It is a program for Wiener filter for image restoration. So we want the unnecessary windows of MATLAB to get closed, the variables into the workspace that you see that also get cleared, and the clear screen onto the command window. So we begin with the commands, close all, simply clear, and CLC. The first module, now we can begin to read the input image for the purpose to have the degradation first of all, and then application of Wiener type of filtering. So the module, it will be reading input image to the MATLAB script here. The usual allocation of the image sample to the MATLAB script I make to the variable capital A. So capital A shall be operated with the MATLAB syntax I am read, and here I shall be mentioning the name of the image that I want to get. So here I shall make, that is peacock.jpg. So let us take this input image. So I save this particular program with, let us say, the program name program2.m that has appeared here as well to the current directory. So if we run this, so we simply have variable A, the only one that has been generated. So initially we have not transformed it right from the RGB domain to that of the grayscale image. Hence it has 792 by 1056, the two dimensions, the spatial dimensions, and number of bands are 3, representing the red, green and blue. So here for this input image having the 3 bands, we want a shift from RGB to gray. Hence we have the computation A is equal to, here the resultant type we want double, inside the parenthesis we use the command RGB to gray applicable again to capital A. And now we hold the dimensions of the input image with the variable names capital M and N. So it shall be possible with the help of MATLAB command size here, the input shall be again capital A. So the script at this level we save, and let us check whether the variables are appeared into the workspace or not. So now you can see 792 by 1056. So it is not having any 3 bands, a very single band we have with M and N holding the 2 dimensions. So now we have the input image taken into this particular MATLAB program. Now for the degradation function, we want this particular block here. So here we mention a comment here. So for degradation function, we shall be utilizing the variable name small h, and initially it shall be holding a matrix of all the coefficients having the value 1 here. So the syntax is once here at this time we provide the dimensions 5 by 5 here, and for the normalization purpose we divide it by the square of 5 or the product 5 by 5, it will be simply 25. So this way the very two important things to go to proceed with the Wiener type of filtering for image restoration we have, that is input image and the degradation function. Now as this particular process is to be carried into the frequency domain, we just make the use of direct transformation, that is 2D DFT. Let us have it with the comment, that is transformation to frequency domain. So here we have the variable names FREQ underscore A to hold the frequency domain representation for the input data, that is FFT2 computed for capital A. Similar task should be there for the degradation function or simply the filter mask we can say. So here the variable FREQ underscore H we can generate, and the computation shall be by again the same task, that is FFT2 command, and here the input shall be of three types, that is the degradation function represented by H, and for the dimensions of the same kind as that of the input image we mentioned capital M and capital N within the parenthesis. So this we terminate with the semicolon. So now we are into the frequency domain to compute the Wiener type of filtering for image restoration. Now to show you the degraded image into the spatial domain, we proceed with the next module. So here we comment degraded image in spatial domain. So for degraded image to be holded, we use the variable capital B. Let us compute it for the real part. For spatial domain, we want the inverse Fourier transform to work. Hence the command IFFT2 shall be applicable, and within the parenthesis we shall be giving it the input of the product of coefficient to coefficient with the two matrices that are represented by FREQ underscore H with that of FREQ underscore A here, because the matrix to matrix multiplication simply into the frequency domain shall be the convolution into the spatial domain. So now we have this task actually added with the another noise for the degradation purpose, that is computed by 25 in multiplication with, this is the command RANDN, and here the input shall be for the same dimensions of the input image M and N here. So we save this much and we check whether the variable B is generated here or not. Yes, here it is generated. So now we can proceed further for the purpose of Wiener filtering. So I mention here Wiener filtering. So we have the variables FREQ underscore B. It shall be holding FFT2 command operated onto the B to get it back to the frequency domain. We have another variables POW underscore B to represent the powers. So here we have the computation of absoluteness for FREQ underscore B. Just now we have computed, and we shall give it a power 2 divided by the product of the two dimensions M and that of the N here. Terminating with semicolon. Now having the two more parameters for Wiener filtering purpose, that is sigma here first of all. So sigma we hold with the value initially 50. Similar variable we require, that is gamma. The gamma initially we hold with the value 1. We also require another variable alpha that actually indicates the Wiener type of filtering. So this alpha right now is holding the value 1 here. Now we have the computation of S FREQ underscore H for the further purpose, and it shall be computed as FREQ underscore H matrix to matrix coefficient product with that of the absolute of, here we have FREQ underscore H, that is greater than 0. Now it shall be added with the 1 divided by gamma here with the product of, here we have the absolute of FREQ underscore H. So this should be equal to 0. So here we end this particular syntax. Then we compute I FREQ underscore H pi 1 having the dot division with that of the S FREQ underscore H that just now we have computed. Now we make the computation further for I FREQ H. It shall be by I FREQ underscore H, the coefficient to coefficient multiplication with that of the, inside the bracket here we mention the absolute form of FREQ underscore H, and this time it should have the product with that of the gamma greater than 1 here. So now we carry it forward for gamma in product with the absolute of, here we have S FREQ underscore H, the coefficient multiplications with I FREQ underscore H again the multiplication with that of the absolute portion or S FREQ underscore H here in the multiplication with that of the gamma, and we can put the condition that is less than or equal to 1 here. So now we compute another variable POW underscore B as we name it. So now the computation shall follow. The earlier POW underscore B, the coefficient multiplication with, here we provide the conditions, that is POW underscore B, that is greater than sigma square. So we provide the sigma square here, and it has been divided by, within the bracket we can have POW underscore B, the power form, that is subtracted by the bracket 1 minus alpha here. The bracket is completed and it is having the product with sigma square. So this way we have computed this particular variable. We proceed further for the script of finishing the Wiener filtering. So here we have the computation of FREQ underscore G, and now here we shall represent the restored image by the variable name RES. As we are into the frequency domain, we give underscore FREQ underscore A I mention, and here the computed FREQ underscore G with the dot multiplication of every coefficient with respect to FREQ underscore B here. So now this is the time to represent the image, restored image, into the spatial domain. Hence I mentioned the comment here, this is restored image in spatial domain, and now here we have the representation by RES underscore A computed as the real part using the inverse Fourier transform onto the two dimensions. Hence the command IFFT2 operated onto the recent variable RES underscore FREQ underscore A that has been computed above. So I save this much of script and run this particular program. So you can see all the variables that we tried to compute for the winner type of filtering in image restoration have got generated into the workspace. Now the task is completed by just having a display of the original and the output images. So we get the last module here. So here we mention display of input and output images. So for display purpose, we shall be using imshow command. So this is imshow, and the input shall be the variable capital A, but initially it is into the double type here. So let us making it uint A to type. Now A is provided. The title we can mention so that the image can be distinguished among the other windows here. So this is our original image. By the next line, we should be able to show the degraded image. So for that purpose, for having a separate window to represent the figure, we have this particular command figure, and then we use imshow for the variable capital B. It is also into the double type, hence at this time also uint 8 should be the data type that particular variable should have. And now at this place we can mention the title, that is of degraded image. Now the last line of the script, it shall again involve the figure to separate out the command having the display of the image. So it shall be having the imshow of the restored image that is holded by res underscore a. So let us make it of type uint 8 and giving the input as res underscore a. The last title to the third window here. So this is our restored image after Wiener filtering. So this completes our script. We have saved the changes. We run this program and expect the three windows here. So here we have figure 1 showing you the original image, the grayscale, that is peacock.jpg. The second window, here we have the degraded form of the image, and by using the Wiener type of filtering, the minimum square error method, here we have the restored image by that particular one. So here the restoration is up to some certain level. So this we have checked onto the peacock.jpg. Here we can also check it onto the another type of input images. We can check the result onto the having myna.jpg. So let us check the results. Here we have the first window representing the original image, the second window representing the degraded image, and the third window representing the restored image after Wiener type of filtering. So I hope this program must have benefited you to understand how exactly the Wiener filtering works for the purpose of image restoration. By the next lecture, we shall discuss the topic, that is maximum likelihood method of image restoration. Again, the purpose is to have betterment of result recovered if the image is degraded or noise affected. So if you like the topics and want to understand the digital image processing in more details, you can subscribe to eKIDA channel. Thank you.